We are starting with a glimpse of Melbourne, the second largest city of Australia, with a population of a little more than 5 million. Melbourne is a city of contrast. Streetcars and elegant avenues are contrasting with Victorian architecture and modern skyscrapers. Especially the streetcars and classical building facades lend the city a certain charm which other Australian more modern cities lack. The city is an important industrial and until recently also the largest financial centre of Australia, but has since been ousted to second rank by Sydney. Between Sydney and Melbourne seems to prevail a constant rivalry, which an Australian friend defined that the people of Sydney drive around in Rolls Royces financed by their credits, whereas the inhabitants of Melbourne are content with Volkswagens, which, however, are fully paid. We had today planned to leave on an excursion, but we have difficulties to leave this wonderful swimming pool. Eventually, we have decided to visit the Keppel Island by boat. The archipelago to which this island belongs was discovered by Captain Cook on his famous trip in 1770 and was named in honor of Admiral Keppel. The ferry dismisses us on a totally empty beach and we discover very quickly that there is nothing to see at all. Permanent inhabitants here are these colorful rainbow parrots. They have become so accustomed to people that they have partly become a plague. We have been explicitly warned not to feed them, as they are very trusting but can become very aggressive and dangerous when they don't get what they want. Fortunately, after a few hours, a boat picks us up from the still totally empty beach. We are very disappointed with this excursion and should have stayed in the swimming pool. The next day sees us driving away from the coast into the hilly and wooded backcountry, where our first stop leads us to the Josephine Waterfall. It is located at the foot of one of the highest mountains in this region, which, however, is only 1,622 meters high. Very close, there are three more waterfalls embedded in thick vegetation. In less than 1 hour by car northbound, we reach the rainforest where the Daintree River flows into the Coral Sea. A boat excursion permits us a glimpse of Mother Nature rarely seen. As an example, this strangler tree, which clenches a normal tree with its fingers until it suffocates and dies. Our guide points out that there are also a lot of crocodiles which presently are hiding because of the heat. In winter, one can, however, observe them when they are out in the sun. Very high in these treetops live some 20,000 bats, of which we can spot only a few. From this distance, they seem to be of a considerable size. The veranda of our room lies directly at this romantic pool, and in the absence of other guests in this hotel, we have it to our exclusive disposal. Again, it is difficult to leave this luxury behind, but we have decided to visit one of the Whitsun Islands, which are situated in the Great Barrier Reef. Each of these islands is a tropical paradise with fantastic beaches, untouched by forests and cliffs. Many are uninhabited. The excursion includes a picnic, swimming, and snorkeling. Eventually, our ship ties up with an anchored yellow submarine from which we are being transferred with a smaller boat to the sandy beach. Now is the time to get acquainted with the snorkel and to swim to the nearby coral reef. Coral reefs can become as hard as cement, but are not stones. They consist of tiny corallites which colonize mainly just below sea levels. After our underworld excursion, we are having a delicious picnic. Regretfully, we have to think about our return. To say goodbye to our friends, the fish, we are offering them a meal. Today, our destination is Cairns, a small town which became well known as a gateway to the Great Barrier Reef. The drive from the hilly backcountry with its rainforest to the plains leads us past totally empty beaches to Cairns, where we are taking a room at the Hilton Hotel. A scary-looking grasshopper could not deter us from relaxing in the pool from today's excursion. Herewith, we terminate our glimpse of Australia.